Hello students and hello viewers. I am Sir Von, your computer teacher. At nakikita nyo dito sa screen yung cover page ng ating module. Please find time to read your module. Especially yung mga iba't ibang components, meron tayong find out, try it, meron din tayong discover, assess, and additional. Makikita natin ang copyright at development team ng module sa computer. Makikita din natin dito ang teacher contact details. So, ugaliin, kontakin ang inyong teacher, especially sa akin, sa computer, kung may mga katanungan din. Makikita dito sa screen. Welcome again, class. This is your teacher, Mr. Von P. Gabayan Jr. This is Computer 9 ICT in the 21st century. The main topic of our computer subject, grade 9, will be computer hardware servicing. That's why our first lesson is computer basics. So under computer basics class, you will know all the components of the computer, what is computer, the classification of computer, personal, and the types of personal computers. Now, let's proceed with our lesson. So, first, this is your progress tracker. You need to fill up your name, fill in your name here, your section, and there are different parts or components of your module. We have here the introduction or the find out, the activity, the discover, activity again, and keep in mind, and the assessment. So in here, you will fill up this progress tracker during your schedule. Our schedule for computer is Thursday. So write the date and the time and the action. Once you finish the first component or the second component. And right there, what have I learned from my lesson today? What did I find easy in my lesson activity today? And what did I find difficult this day? So right there, also, what do I need to do next day? Okay? So you need to fill up this along the way. Next. So our first lesson is computer basics, wherein the target most essential learning competency of this lesson is describe what is computer and identify the classification of computer. And at the end of this module, you are expected to define computer and explore the classification of computers and types of personal computer. Now let's proceed to the introduction. Okay, as many of today's basic functions are being simplified by technology, computers have been on the forefront in developing innovations through its many functions. So many of the things that we thought were impossible before are now being achieved by computer nowadays. So pwede na tayong gumamit ng computer para makapagbayad ng mga bills natin. Shop online or connect with other people, most especially on social media nowadays. Maraming pamilya ang kinoconnect ng social media, especially Facebook. And in this digital economy, having the knowledge and skills in computer servicing is the start and most fundamental at all. So kailangan mo, bago mo mapag-aralan yung mga iba't iba pang components or iba't iba pang languages ng computer, kailangan mong magsimula muna sa computer basic or computer servicing na tinatawag. Kailangan mong malaman yung mga iba't ibang parts ng computer, paano gamitin yung mga parts na ito. So along our 1 year or along this school year, pag-aaralan natin yung lahat ng kailangan yung malaman sa computer hardware servicing or computer servicing na tinatawag. Okay? So, bago natin puntahan yung mga parts, ano nga ba ang computer? So, what is computer? In our module, there is an activity there they try it, you need to define the computer. So, class, a computer works like a human brain. The brain stores information from our senses and then uses this to guide human action. A computer needs information to work on, and it is called data. So, yung mga kailangan ng computer ay tinatawag na data. And a computer can receive and accept data and then processes them using the program set by the user. Data entered into the computer are in the form of text, images, sounds, and videos. And the computer processes this data, then proceeds or produce output information to be used by the people. Process information stored in the computer's memory. So, a computer class is an electronic hardware device. Kaya niyang mag-operate at mag-function under the control or instruction ng isang tao. And kaya nag-operate at nag-function ito dahil meron itong tinatawag na programs. Yung mga programs na yan, class, is stored in its memory. Okay? People use computer as a means to do certain tasks and attain target objectives. Like for example, isang estudyante, kayo, estudyante, gagawa kayo ng PowerPoint presentation nyo. So you will use a computer. Another one is sa mga mall. Gumagamit din sila ng computer sa mall. Like sa cashier, sa office nila, gumagamit sila ng computer. And computer will not work class on their own. Kailangan niya ito ng gagamit sa kanya. Okay? People create and make programs and then use the computer for various applications. Like Adobe Photoshop for editing, Microsoft Office for documents, ganyan, spreadsheet, and PowerPoint presentation. Yun yung mga basic na gamit ng Microsoft Office. And yung mga advanced niya, we have the publishing, we have the Outlook, and so on. And class, sa computer, there are classifications of computer na tinatawag. Pag sinabing classifications of computer, meron tayong tinatawag na supercomputer, mainframe computers, mid-range computers, handheld computers, and microcomputers. Okay? Pag sinabi natin supercomputer class, supercomputers are the most powerful computer available. So take note class. Supercomputer are the most powerful computer available. So these high-capacity computers that run continuously are being used by very large organizations. Mostly class, mga big corporation ang gumagamit ng supercomputer. Okay? At mga government institution. So users of supercomputers are yung computers ng NASA. Okay? Computers ng US government. Sila yung mga mostly gumagamit ng supercomputer. Bakit nila ginagamit? Kasi nga, di ba, supercomputer are the most powerful computer available. Pwedeng maging server ito, pwedeng lagyan ng maraming files, gamitin sa mga gamitin. Okay? Next. Aside from supercomputer class, we have the mainframe computers. Okay? Pag sinabing mainframe computers, these are less powerful than the supercomputer. But this can capable of great processing speed, multitasking capability, and high data storage. So press lang sila with supercomputer, but less powerful lang siya. Okay? There are mostly this mainframe computer are mostly used by banks, mga bangko, mga insurance company para mag-process ng mga information ng depositors or million of daily bank transaction and policy holders. Pag sinabi kasing mainframe computer, pag mga ginagamit ng mga bangko, nasa back end sila ng system. So hindi yan nagikita na pag inopen mo yung internet, hindi siya na-access agad yung mga system ng mga bangko. Including din yung nasa supercomputers, hindi yan na-access ng kahit sa sino lang. So, kung yung company lang na yon yung gagamit, sila lang yung nakaka-access or pwedeng makagalaw dun sa system ng mga computers na yan. Okay? So, lagi nating tandaan, pag supercomputer, most powerful computer available. Pag mainframe computer, less powerful than the supercomputer. At ang mga gumagamit ng mainframe ay mga bangko at mga insurance company. Next, we have the mid-range computer class. Pag sinabing mid-range computer, these are used by medium-sized companies for specific purposes. Okay? Again, medium-sized companies for specific purposes. So they may be used for certain assembly line operations or manufacturing stages in big companies. The size of mid-range computers may be as big as a washing machine, and they may be a standalone system for specialized applications, including network servers. Okay? Yung mid-range computer, mostly ginagamit ito ng mga call centers, mga computer shops, pwede din. Okay? So, yung mga company na yon may specific purpose kung bakit nila ginagamit ito. Like, they will store huge amount of data dito sa computer nila, or it can be the server of the company, ganyan. Okay? Next is the handheld computer class. Pag tinabing handheld computer, these are the smallest computer that are designed to fit in one hand or palm. That is why they are also called as the palm top computer. Pag sinabing handheld computers, it also called palm top computers. Okay? Itong handheld computer class, this computer may combine pen inputs, yung mga stylus, personal organizer tools, and communication capabilities such as telephone and internet applications. So personal digital assistant or the PDA were the most common palm-top or handheld computer. Pag sinabing personal digital assistant, ito yung nakikita niya dito sa screen nyo ngayon. Yan. Isang example yan ng personal digital assistant or DPDA. Later on, i-explain ko sa inyo yung mga iba't ibang personal computer na pwedeng magamit. Okay? So, yung handheld computer, kasali din dito class yung mga smartphones. Okay? Ngayon kasi, today's handheld computer are dominated by smartphones. Pag sinabi kasing smartphones, it incorporate all of the above features in one device. Ano ba yung mga features na yon? Unang-una, organizer siya. Pangalawa, kaya niya yung computer applications, kaya din niya ng camera, meron siyang audio, meron siyang video capabilities. Okay? So smartphones are now widely used all over the world for communication purposes. Take note. Smartphones are now widely used all over the world for communication purposes, but are also used in various applications via the internet or stand alone. So yun yung gamit ng handheld computers. Again, pag sinabing handheld computers, ito yung mag-fit lang sa kamay natin, like the personal digital assistant and the smartphones or the cell phones. Next is, or lastly, we have the microcomputers. Pag sinabing microcomputers, ito yung mga desktop computer. Okay? Desktop computers are the most common and widely used computer nowadays. Not only desktop computer, meron din tayong mga laptops na tinatawag. Itong laptops at desktop computer, ginagamit ito sa bahay, sa eskwelahan, at sa mga businesses na nakikita nyo dyan sa palengke, ganyan, sa city, and sa malls. There are two types of microcomputer. Yun nga yung sabi ko, yung desktop computer and yung laptop or the notebook computer. Okay? Now, desktop computers are small enough to be placed on a desk or table. But these are too big to be carried around. Okay? Saan ka naman nakakita ng tao na yung desktop computer niya, bubuhatin niya yan at pupunta siya sa ibang lugar? Okay? Hindi. Sa desk lang siya, sa bahay lang siya, or school, or sa business lang. Naka-stand alone lang siya na hindi siya chargeable. Next is yung notebook computer or yung tinatawag nating laptop computer. Ito yung portable lang sa class. Lightweight siya and easy to carry around. Yung pwede mo siyang madala kahit saan. Pwede mong idala sa ibang lugar. And lastly, a tablet personal computer is a fancy notebook. Pag sinabing tablet personal computer, ito yung merong swivel design and it can accept handwriting using a digital pen. Okay? Mostly ngayon, yung mga tablet personal computer, yung mga touchscreen na yan, naka-incorporate sa laptop. May mga laptop na ngayon na touchscreen. Okay? And may mga laptops na din ngayon na wala na siyang keyboard. Pwede mong tanggalin yung keyboard, pwede mong i-flip lang siya na pwedeng maging tablet lang siya. Okay? So yun yung mga classification, iba't ibang classification ng computer. Again, we have the supercomputer, yan yung most powerful computer available. Next is the mainframe computer. It is the same with the supercomputer, but it is less powerful. Next is the mid-range computer. Pag sinabing mid-range computer, merong specific purpose yung gamit niya. Fourth one is the handheld computer. Fit lang siya sa kamay mo. Kaya nga, handheld, or it is also called as palm top. And lastly, microcomputer. Ito yung desktop at laptop computers natin. Okay? Our next topic in your module is the personal computers. There are 9 personal computers available. Gaya nga ng pagkakasabi ko, yung desktop computer, desktop lang siya, standalone, hindi mo siya pwedeng dalhin sa ibang lugar na pwede mong magamit. Okay? Kasi pag sinabing desktop, siniset up mo pa siya in a desk. Kailangan mo pa ng electric power source. Okay? Kaya it is more, mas maganda yung laptop computer na dalhin sa kung saan-saan lugar. Kasi itong laptop computer, di ba, rechargeable siya. Meron siyang battery. Pwede mo siyang magamit. Okay? Desktop computer class is a personal computer in a setup wherein it is located on a desk or a table. Yun nga yung sabi ko kanina. While laptop computers are also called notebook computers, these are small personal computers where components, display, keyboard, pointing devices, CPU or the system unit, and rechargeable battery are packed together in one single portable unit intended for mobile use. Okay? Next gen class is yung multi-touch. Meron tayong tinatawag na multi-touch computers or multi-touch screen. Ang multi-touch screen is a computer monitor screen that will allow the interaction of two or more fingers direction into the screen to give a command. Okay? Example ng multi-touch screens are yung ATM machines natin. ATM machine ng mga bangko or kapag nakapunta kayo sa mga fast food like Jollibee, ganyan, like McDonald's, gumagamit sila ng multi-touch screen in taking orders. Pag kumuha sila ng order sa inyo, yan yung ginagamit nila, multi-touch screen. Meron din tayong tinatawag class na nettop. Pag sinabing nettop, ito yung mga desktop computer na small size lang. Low voltage and lower power computer. It is relatively cheap, making it ideal for internet tasks and basic word processing, spreadsheet, PowerPoint, and playing music or video. Most laptops have built-in Wi-Fi. So yun lang yung nagagawa ng NetApp Plus. Kaya lang niya na word processing, spreadsheet, PowerPoint, playing music or video, ganyan. Tsaka basic internet surfing or internet tasks. Nakaka-search ka lang. Other than that, wala na siyang gamit. Next class is yung tinatawag nating netbook. Ang netbook class, it is also called as mini notebook. Pag sinabing mini notebook, it was conceived and released to the public in 2007 while the release of Asus PC, yun, with the release of Asus PC, I should say. Since then, it is rapidly evolved and improved. Nag-improve yung mga netbook class. Napapansin ninyo ngayon, may mga netbook na small size laptop. Yun yung tinatawag yung netbook ngayon. So, pwede mong gamitin yan, the same as laptop, the same features as laptop, pwede mong gamitin sa yung netbook. Okay? Ang pinagkaiba lang ng netbook sa laptop, yung laptop meron siyang CD-ROM, yung netbook, hindi siya pwedeng lagyan ng CD. Okay? Next is tablet PC. Ito na yung sinasabi ko sa inyo kanina na meron ng mga personal computers or meron ng mga computers na touch screen. So, yan yung mga tablet PC. Pag sinabing tablet PC class, it is a notebook equipped with touch screen which allow the user to operate the computer using a digital pen or stylus. Okay? But mostly nowadays, pwede na yung finger mong gamitin. Pwede mong gamitin tablet mo using your finger. Okay? Next class is the pocket PC. Pag sinabing pocket PC class, it is a handheld or pocket-sized computer running on Microsoft Windows Pocket PC Edition with all the features of a modern desktop PC. Mostly class yung pocket PC na yan. Kukunti na lang gumagamit dito class ngayon. Even the personal digital assistant na tinatawag. Itong pocket PC at personal digital assistant, na-overthrown sila or na-exceed yung expectation ng smartphone. Okay? Na-explain ko naman na kanina yung PDA or your personal digital assistant. So, let's proceed sa smartphone. Ang smartphone, si class, nagagawa na niya lahat. Pwede kang mag-type dyan ng under word processing, spreadsheet, PowerPoint presentation, playing music, playing video, capturing picture, mag-selfie, mag-internet surfing, mag-send ng text, mag-receive ng text, tumawag, lahat na. Pwede mong gamitin yung smartphone sa lahat na. Okay? Kaya mostly na nire-recommend nila na gumamit ka na lang ng smartphone aside from using the pocket PC or the personal digital assistant. Yung personal digital assistant kasi at pocket PC, hindi siya nasasaksakan ng SIM card. Yung smartphone, syempre, nasasaksakan yan or nasasalpakan ng SIM card. Okay? So again, yung mga iba't ibang personal computers natin class, we have the desktop computer, the laptop computer, multi-touch, net-top, and notebook. We have also the tablet PC, smartphone, pocket PC, and personal digital assistant or the PDA. Okay? So now that you have an idea on the different personal computer, choose what you like most and explain on your module. So, may mga bakanting spaces sa module, i-explain mo ito. Okay? So, that ends our lesson 1 class. So, if you have any question, you can contact me on the following details. So, ito yung mga details. I have here the email address, von.gabayan95@gmail.com. The Facebook account, Bonds Gabayan, and the contact number 0917-501-0809. Don't forget also to subscribe on my YouTube channel, Bonds Learning TV. Okay? Thank you for watching and listening. See you on the next lesson.